Looking back at Tuesday's high, they were all pretty much in the southwestern part of England and along the south coast, and the south coast of Wales as well, getting to around 9 or 10 degrees Celsius. Elsewhere, it's been a colder day for most of us, especially the further north you get. The low temperatures early this morning were in Shap and Capel Curig in elevated locations in northern England and northern Wales. -3, the low, -2 in Aviemore in the Scottish Highlands, and a few other places below freezing in similar areas. Well, let's take a look at what the picture is right now, and you can see how things have been progressing this afternoon. It's been a murky day for a lot of us, and there's a rain band moving through tonight, late evening for the southwestern part of England, into western parts of the country, into Scotland, and reaching eastern shores just about by morning. Quite cool temperatures as well, 3 to 5 degrees Celsius, could fall as sleet in some parts of Scotland, but probably only on elevated locations. Behind this band, it's not too bad a day for parts of western coasts of the UK on Wednesday. You can see there most of the rain has left us by the afternoon, with high temperatures of around 7 to 10 Celsius in the southwest there, 10 degrees, struggling to get to 5 or 6 in Scotland, however. So going to feel chilly, definitely. And looking at Wednesday evening into Thursday morning, you'll see in most areas things clearing up quite a bit, which means it's going to be a cold night for a lot of us, especially down that central corridor there. And in Scotland, it's going to be very cold in some areas, below freezing quite substantially in some areas rurally. So into Thursday, on the eastern coast there, it's looking a little bit bland, a little bit of rain perhaps there under the cloud, but the rest of us looking like we're going to have a very good day on Thursday, with clear skies in many areas indeed, but only 3 to 6 degrees generally, and as you can see also the winds are very much down as a general rule there, maybe a little bit more in the northeast, but nothing special in terms of wind. And now you can see as we enter Friday morning, that other band moving in from the west with a huge wall of cloud, which hasn't quite reached the UK by Friday morning. It's going to be a clear night, and that means it's going to be much colder, especially further west where the winds are lighter and below freezing in many areas, quite possibly Thursday night into Friday morning. Looking at Friday itself, the cloud will build up throughout the day, but some areas will remain clear throughout, probably further east, but further west we'll probably see more cloud building up and perhaps a slight increase in temperature, but I don't think it will be particularly notable. 8 or 9 in the southwest, a wind starting to increase as we enter Friday evening with this band moving in, and it's going to mainly be predominantly cloudy, but areas in central parts of England and into Scotland later on in the evening will stay fairly clear, so it's going to be another chilly one further north, but further south you can see the temperatures a little bit higher, staying above freezing in quite a large area of England and Wales. And into Saturday you can see the southwest starting to get some rainfall, a little bit far out in the model run now, so this might change slightly, but in the southwest of England and Wales it looks like we'll get some rain there. Cloudy in the south, clearer in the north again, and you can see the wind profile there, 5 to 8 degrees Celsius is going to be your high. And looking at a Saturday evening, a little bit dull and rainy in the Irish Sea, and possibly some rain for the Isle of Man there into Sunday morning, and but most of us should remain dry actually, and partly cloudy skies generally, with perhaps clear skies further north again in Scotland, which means again another biting frost and freeze, possibly down to -4 or -5 in the Northern Highlands. And looking at Sunday then, you can see this real big rain band moving through. It is speculative because it's late on in the model run, but you can see it moving in there, and it hasn't quite reached many of us by Sunday afternoon, just the Western Isles, but temperatures will be on the increase between 5 and 9 degrees Celsius. Well, you can visit the website force13.com/UKWarn for the latest warnings when there are any, but that's all for now. We'll have another update with the UK weather very shortly indeed, to give you a picture of what's to come. That's all for now. Goodbye.